Good afternoon, all of you. Welcome to Combined YouTube Live Classes to 9th class conducted by TEO Suryapet and Kammam. We are in the lesson Adaptations to Different Ecosystems. We already learned about what is habitat, what is an ecosystem, and the differences between habitat and ecosystem. And different factors that affect an ecosystem and different components of ecosystem. We know that adaptation is a special feature of an organism to survive in special habitats or special conditions. I have learned about different ecosystems in earlier classes, and we are in water ecosystem. We have already learned about marine water ecosystem. Today we are going to learn about freshwater ecosystem.
Okay, we are in the lesson Adaptations to Different Ecosystems, and now we are going to learn about freshwater ecosystems. We already learned about marine water ecosystems. There are two types of these freshwater ecosystems. They are running water types and another one is stagnant type. You know, there are many examples for this stagnant water ecosystems. They may vary in size from as small as a puddle and pond to a large lake or river, etc. Usman Sagar, Durgam Cheru, Shamirpet Lakes of Hyderabad, and Vedapalli Cheru, Lucknowaram of Warangal, Paleru Cheru in our Kammam district. These are all examples of stagnant water ecosystems, and you know, River Godavari, Krishna, some examples of different running water ecosystems. Just like the marine ecosystems, to study environmental conditions in lake, some zones are marked. The littoral zone and the limnatic zone, and the last one is profundal zone. Based on availability of light and different kinds of organisms are found in these zones. Different facts like light, salt content, food, oxygen affect the organisms and their populations in different ways. Just like the marine ecosystems, to study environmental conditions in lakes or rivers, some zones are marked here. The littoral zone, the limnatic zone, this is the limnatic zone, and the last one is profundal zone. Based on availability of light, different kinds of organisms are found in these zones. Different factors like light, salt content, food, oxygen affect the organisms and their populations in different ways. This is littoral zone. The shallow zone near the shore. The shallow zone near the shore is also called as littoral zone. The water near the shore is usually muddy or turbid. The topmost and warmest zone on the edge of water body is home to many snails, clams, insects, several crustaceans. These are different examples of animals that lives on the littoral zone. Several organisms in those zones have well-developed sight, usually have dull and grayish bodies and are fast swimmers. You can see different animals here. This is frog. This is amphibia, the larvae of dragonfly. And these are the examples of different plants in littoral zone. This is a moss plant. This is water lily, and this is Wallisneria, and this is Typha. These are all examples of plants which grow in littoral zone. These plants need very low water levels. Next zone is limnatic zone. The limnatic zone is the open water zone at the top of the water body. This lies at the top of water, where the light can travel very abundantly. This zone contains a variety of freshwater fish with bright, shiny grays or silver black scales. You can see different fishes like this. They have very bright and shiny scales to hide them from predators, because they can merge into surrounding water. These are some examples which you can see at the top of the lake. That is a limnatic zone. This is Cyclops and this is Daphnia. These are arthropods. You can see in upper part of the lake, that is limnatic zone. These are different plants which you can see at limnatic zone. This is Wolfia and this is water hyacinth and this is Pistia. Different plants have different adaptations to grow at this zone. These are all flat. These all plants are floating plants. You can see the adaptations which are present in different plants that present at limnatic zone. This is water hyacinth, and here you can see Erenchyma. You can see Erenchyma here, which helps in floating and transporting gases to submerged parts of the plant. This is hydrilla. The shallow zone near the shore is called as littoral zone. This zone is called as littoral zone. The water near the shore is as usually muddy or turbid. The water near the shore is usually muddy or turbid because more soil enters into the water. Usually the animals present at the littoral zone are snails, clams, insects, several crustaceans like you can see different animals present at littoral zone here. These amphibians and starties, these are larvae of dragonflies. These are the larvae of dragonflies. Several organisms in this zone have well-developed sight because abundant light present at this zone. So they have well-developed sight. You can see different plants which present at the littoral zone. You can see mosses, water lily, typha, vallisneria. High photosynthetic activity occurs in this zone. Most of the food is produced at this zone only in this ecosystem. In this ecosystem, most of the photosynthetic activity occurs here, and most of the food is produced at this zone only. And then predators of this zone are tortoise, snakes, and ducks, etc. Next one, limnatic zone. Limnatic zone is the open water zone. This present at the top of water body and consequently receives a good deal of light. It have abundant light. So some of algae present and some floating plants called as phytoplanktons. They also present at this zone. This zone contains a variety of freshwater fish. You can see different fish here. You can observe that they have bright shiny scales. They help them to merge with the surroundings. You can see different microorganisms like Daphnia and Cyclops. This is Cyclops and this is Daphnia. These belong to crustaceans. They have, you can see here, they are they have transparent body. These help, these transparent bodies help them to hide from predators. You can see different plants here. These are floating plants, also called as phytoplankton. This is Wolfia. This is water hyacinth. This is Pistia. These plants have different adaptations to survive and to float on the water. You can see here parenchyma, which helps the floating plants to transport air to different plant, different parts of the body, and as well as they help in floating. You can see water here hyacinth with swollen petiole. We can see here water hyacinth with the swollen petiole, which helps in floating. You can see hydrilla. Hydrilla is well adapted to water ecosystem because it can absorb CO2 very well from the surroundings, and the leaves of this hydrilla has no stomata, and this can reproduce by asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Next, third one is probundle zone. The last two, the littoral and limnatic zones, both are photic zones, but this doesn't get abundant light. It is dimly lit and cold. Mostly heterotrophs are found in this region. Most of the animals that so-called bottom dwellers that live here are mostly scavengers and predators. Because they don't get any light, so this is very hard to find photosynthetic organisms here, because they don't get light, so they cannot perform photosynthesis. So you cannot find any photosynthetic organisms. Photosynthetic organisms mean plants here. So mostly scavengers or predators present at this zone. This is one of the examples which you can see at profundal zone, that is Glossogobius. This is predator fish. And these are crustaceans, examples of organisms present at profundal zone. Actually, these organisms adapt themselves by feeding on dead animals that settled down. Many kinds of bacteria also present here. They help in decomposing the dead organisms. Mud on the bottom floor, tiny particles of dead and decaying matter of plants and animals' bodies make the water very turbid, so they can't see. And light is also very low, so they can't see. And so they rely mostly on smell and auditory senses rather than vision to acquire their food. So auditory and smell organs are very developed in these organisms. They use eyes very less. The surface layers in the lake ecosystem gets heated while the deeper layers remain cool during the daytime. So some of the animals may travel to deep layers of the water and come back during night. So some animals may present at daytime and may not present at night time. And other organisms found in lake. You can see different mammals here. This is beaver, this is badger, and this is otter. These live near water and are capable of swimming to catch their main food source, particularly fish. You have studied about beaver in animal behavior. Already we have studied about this in our lesson behavior. And these also play a main role in maintaining freshwater ecosystem. And you can see different amphibians. This is salamander, which can be seen at freshwater ecosystem. These are the eggs of frog, and this is the larva of frog, playing a critical role in supplying food. These amphibians start life underwater as eggs and tadpoles. As eggs and tadpoles, these are present in underwater, but as they grow, then they move to ground as adults. Some insects also present at this ecosystem. Insects such as skaters, water beetles, and mosquitoes, dragonflies. These are also present at this ecosystem, and these are playing a critical role in the food supply for other animals also. Insects such as skaters, water beetles, dragonfly, mosquito, these can swim over the surface of ponds, and these are playing a critical role in the food supply for other animals. Many species of ducks, cranes, and swans also reside in and around the lake ecosystem. They are feeding on a number of different items, including fish. And many species of ducks, cranes, etc. lives in this ecosystem. And these webbed feet, which some water birds have, and long legs, long beaks, also cranes have. These special features helps them to survive in water ecosystems. These webbed feet helps ducks to swim easily in the water, and these long legs helps cranes to stay in water without drowning, and these long beaks help in catching fish inside water. Here is an activity for you. Do this and submit to your teacher. Collect pictures of different water birds and animal pictures. After collecting that pictures, observe the different features that help them to live better in water. You observe the pictures and find out what special features they have and how they help to live better in water. Write down the features in your notebook. After identifying special features of that animals and birds, then you have to write down the features in your notebook and show it to your teacher. Collect different plants from nearby lake. Try to take help of elders to collect when collecting these plants. Observe them. Observe transverse section of stems under microscope. Observe external features and observe internal features also by transverse sections under microscope. After that, you have to write down the special features. You have to compare different plants which are present, which are terrestrial and aquatic. Compare and find differences. If there is any special feature, you have to write down in your notebook and show it to your teacher. Write down the special features that help them to survive in water. You have to find that special features which are present in aquatic plants. Thank you. Thank you very much.